today's Mention My Name Mass is to honour those who have lost their lives by suicide. To honour them, to remember who they were, to reflect on how they touched our lives. Suicide is the death that no one really wants to talk about. And today, we honour through this Mass those who are no longer with us, who have died by suicide. We also honour and we remember those that they have left behind. Families, work colleagues, caregivers, the first responders. Today's Mass is to honour all of them as well. Thank you.
Good morning. On behalf of the parish community of St Thomas More Catholic Church, Roos, parish priest, Father Michael Healy, I'd like to welcome you today, and for those watching on the live stream, to this Memorial Mass, where we remember those who have lost their lives through suicide, and pray for their grieving family, friends, caregivers, and first responders. Love is kind. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. Today, we pay our respects to the traditional custodians of the land we are privileged to gather on today. We pay our respects to them and are grateful for the care of this land. May we walk gently on this land forever and together. Let us pause and bring to our hearts and minds the names and the faces of those who we come to remember today. Would you mention my name every day when you pray? When talking to others, will you mention me? You don't have to bother with tending to me. If I had one request that I knew you could fill, here's what the longing would be. Every morning and every evening, maybe sometimes in between, loved ones, would you please mention my name and remember me? Would you all please stand?
To my heart, loved and forgiven. And I welcome you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. I'd like to join Gerard in really welcoming you all to this special celebration today. Our celebration with God. You know, that's what Mass is. We're celebrating Mass, celebrating our meeting, special celebration with God and with the Church. I welcome those of you who are present here. I know we're few in number. Why? Because a tiny, tiny little virus has excluded so many others. Isn't it nice to know, though, that not even COVID could exclude from this Mass those of you who are joining us today by live streaming. You are most welcome. Because together, we are with the one God, the God who knows and loves each of us where we are and as we are, and loves us infinitely in that way. He doesn't have favorites, you know. We're all equal before him. Isn't it nice to think that there's not one of us who has a monopoly on God? So let's ask him to make his presence really felt to us today, even if our hearts may still be a little bit full of hurt or sadness or anger or loss. And we pause for a moment now to call to mind the fact that we're all sinners. We all have our faults and failings. We ask God to help to forgive us and to help us to be better. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of God and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We now sit and listen to God's word as God speaks to us from the Bible.
A reading from the prophet Zechariah. Raising my eyes, I saw a vision. It was this. There was a man with a measuring line in his hand. I asked him, "Where are you going?" He said, "To measure Jerusalem, to find out her breadth and her length." And then, while the angel who was talking to me stood still, another angel came forward to meet him. He said to him, "Run and tell that young man this. Jerusalem is to remain unwalled because of the great number of men and cattle there will be in her. But I, it is the Lord who speaks, I will be a wall of fire for her all around her and will be her glory in the midst of her. Sing, rejoice, daughter of Zion, for I am coming to dwell in the middle of you. It is the Lord who speaks. Many nations will join the Lord. On that day, they will become his people." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will guard.
Stand to greet the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At a time when everyone was full of admiration for all that he did, Jesus said to his disciples, "For your part, you must have these words constantly in your mind, the Son of Man is going to be handed over into the power of men." But they didn't understand what he had said to them. And he said this, "It was hidden from them so that they should not see the meaning of it, and they were afraid to ask him about what he had just said." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, we're here this morning at St. Thomas More Church in Roos, and you at home are joining us live streaming. We're sharing this Mass together. We're joining together because a dear one has died. A family member, a relative, a spouse, someone close to us in our neighborhood, in our profession, in our workplace, the people we're talking about and thinking about attempted or committed suicide. There's a bond and an understanding between us at this Mass, you know. A bond that unites us, something that others wouldn't really understand. You see, I mightn't know your name, But in spirit and in the silence of my heart, I silently mention a name to you today. And you, in the silence of your hearts, mention a name to me. And then we take these names together to our God. I believe that we say to each other today, in our hearts, that lovely Aussie statement that has, in its most beautiful traditional meaning, "You're my mate." And then we take it all to our God. We know better than others that suicide is a tragedy. Nobody copes well with tragedy. Suicide is the least glamorous and the most misunderstood of all forms of death. What needs to be said about suicide? Well, I'd like to share with you the main findings of the majority of scholarly studies carried out by medical, psychological, and pastoral experts that we need to hear, and certainly we need to understand. Firstly, they tell us, and most importantly, in most cases, suicide is the result of a disease, a sickness, an illness, a tragic breakdown within the emotional immune system. Technically, the experts call it a, put this in your pipe and smoke it, they call it a mortal biochemical illness. You see, friends, when people die of cancer or of heart attacks or of strokes or of car accidents, they die against their will. It's not their own choice. And friends, I say to you that the same is very true of in suicide. In the past, and I suppose even in the present for some people worry unduly about the salvation of a suicide victim. I suppose I understand this because of my job, maybe a bit better than some do. In other words, people who commit suicide, where do they stand with God? The big question asked so regularly, can they get to heaven? Can they enjoy eternal peace with God? Suicide was often seen in the past, and to many today, as the ultimate act of despair. Friends, we got to remember that God's hands are infinitely more understanding and more gentle than our own are. We need not and we should not worry about the fate of anyone, no matter the cause of death, who leaves this world honest or oversensitive, overwrought, emotionally crushed, bruised to the touch, as is the case with most suicides. God's understanding and compassion vastly exceeds our own. A well-known modern theologian summed it up very well, very bluntly, when he said, "Now, don't forget, God isn't stupid, you know." I'm sure that many of us, when we lost a loved one to suicide, might have unduly questioned ourselves. What might I have done? Where did I let this person down? What if? If only I'd been there at the right time. I'd like to share with you, friends, what the experts' findings are. They show that rarely would this have made any difference. Most of the time, we weren't there for the very reason that the person who fell victim to the disease didn't bloomin' well want us to be there. That's one of the strange anomalies about this sickness. Suicide seems to be a disease that picks its victim precisely in such a way as to exclude others and their attentiveness. Suicide is a result of sickness. And friends, there are some sicknesses that all the care and all the love in the whole world cannot cure. And we have to constantly keep reminding ourselves of that fact. In the Bible, God tells us very precisely that when we die, he said, life is changed, not ended. He wants all people, including suicides, to gain an eternal dwelling place with him in heaven. Gosh, we got to remember that. Let's pray at this Mass today that our loved ones whom we remember today may have eternal peace. And also let's pray that one day we will join them in eternity. May they have eternal peace with God in heaven. We are joining together today to pray for our deceased loved ones, but in a special way, to pray for ourselves, to pray for each other, because very often we are the wounded ones who need the healing most. Please stand for the prayers of intercession. My dear friends, the light of Christ's resurrection reveals the immensity of God's mercy. So let's place our trust in the God of mercy and compassion.
For those who have died of suicide, our grandparents, mothers and fathers, uncles and aunties, our children, nieces and nephews, our brothers, sisters and cousins, our friends, neighbours and work colleagues, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the first responders to a suicide death, the doctors, nurses, St. John's Ambulance, firefighters, police, clergy, ministers, and coroners. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from mental illness, depression, anxiety, and those who work in the care and the support of the mentally ill. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been abused and have died of suicide, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who find it hard to forgive and be forgiven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may hold each other in pain and suffering as we remember all who have died. May we continue our bonds with them, calling them by name. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we make all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. And as we come to the offertory of the Mass, the bread and wine that we offer to God is a sign that each of us is offering ourselves to Him today, and in a special way, offering back to Him those who died of tragedy. Pray, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Heavenly Father, we offer this bread and wine today as a sign of our giving of ourselves and in thanksgiving for the gift of others. Receive our gifts, Lord, and particularly the thoughts and inspirations that have brought us together for our Mass today. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions and all the hosts of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Brian, our Bishop, and all the clergy. But remember also our brothers and sisters who have died, particularly those who have died from suicide. They have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now let's all join together in praying to our Heavenly Father a prayer that most of these people who committed suicide would have prayed many times in their lives, the prayer that Jesus himself taught us to pray to our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God. Of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb, that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath.
I feel privileged to have been able to celebrate this Mass with you here today and the many who are watching us at home. Thank you all for your participation and hope that the Lord will touch every one of us with his peace today. Please stand and let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. Almighty God, may we find serenity and tranquility in a world we may not always understand. May the pain that we have known and the chaos and turmoil that we have experienced give us strength to walk through life, facing each new situation with courage and hope.
Amen.
May we always know that there are those who love and understand, that they'll always be there, even when we feel most lost and alone. May a kind word, a reassuring touch, a warm smile be ours every day of our life. And may we give these gifts as well as receive them. May we feel some healing in our brokenness and be able to see light in our darkness. May we piece our lives together and find meaning in our living and with grief. May we remember and mention our loved ones and not so loved ones by name without shame and despair. God, embracing and shining light be upon them forever. And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you all with happiness and peace and contentment and forgiveness and joy, and remain with us all forever.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you once again.
Thank you, Father.
I am here with you by your side, sheltering your heart from the night. Where